Hello everyone, Dunkurtin here, and welcome back to the Nita Cup. Today we are doing a brand new Top Gun style of the competition. So we've got the Nita Cup 600k-4 is what we're calling it, Top Gun. And today we're just doing the first of two competitions that are kind of just together. They're doing a non-lure and a lure competition for this Nita Cup. So this is our non-lure. This is all our participants flying around. This is going to be quite interesting to record this time around, I think, because as you can see, we've got some really fast craft, so it's going to be interesting trying to keep up with everything. Hopefully I'll be able to use this screen a bit to help out with that. So as you can see, we got a lot going on. Just try and get rid of that stuff. So yeah, we got a lot of fast little flyers, and it is Top Gun, so everything is pretty much jets in this competition. So let's just get started. Let's jump right on in with our first matchup for today. Alright, so first up, guys, we have the Vexagon and Lumina from Abye. I believe this is the Vexagon here, and this would be the Lumina, and they'll be going up against the Twin Skulls from Zionix. This is the Twin Skulls from Zionix. Very interesting build here, as you can see, just Twin Skulls, quite literally. I believe they fly with helicopter blades. I haven't really tested everything in action. I just tested that everything flies okay and obeys the rules. So let's speed things back up now and see how we go with our first matchup. And they are off. Alright, sorry, just get myself a bit better orientated, see if I can get in and see any of the action here. We can see a lot of missiles coming out. Wow, a lot of frags there. So for once, I've lifted the ban on frag missiles now. Wow, one of the Twin Skulls already going down. That one took a lot of frag damage, and we can see here the other Twin Skull just taking a direct hit right to the face. Oh, and we have a collision. Wow. So that Twin Skull has just rammed the Vexagon, I believe it is. And now they are both appear to be going down. Is that the Twin Skulls possibly out already for this first matchup? Oh no, we still have missiles coming off. However, parameters for this, considering in play, is unfortunately being above 50 altitude, I believe is what I set it as. So being in the water, they are technically out of play, so I now have to start a timer. Oh wait, looks like this Twin Skull is going to get back up maybe into the desired altitude. If it doesn't, it will be called dead if those balloons cannot lift it far enough. Where is the Lumina? Oh, the Lumina fighter get taken out. Oh, we missed that. It was too busy focusing on what was happening with the Twin Skulls there. Sorry, guys. Just too focused on that collision. It looks like the Twin Skulls might have actually won this. If the Lumina and Vexagon don't have anything left in the air... Wow. So yeah, we were just too focused there on that collision there that we seem to have missed whatever happened to the Lumina fighter. Just gonna go out and see if we can see anything. So that's... This looks like the wreckage of the Lumina falling down, yes. We've got the Twin Skulls and the Vexagon over here. So yeah, that is the Lumina. Still got some missiles firing off down here by the looks of it, towards the Vexagon. These are flares by the looks of it. I actually haven't been playing this game for a while, so some of these things are going to be quite new to me, actually, guys. I haven't seen the EMP or flares really in action yet. However, while the Vexagon is still firing, it's technically out of play, and does not look like it's going to be coming back up anytime soon. So yeah, due to the fact that this is fighter jet competition. Unfortunately, if you're grounded in the water after a certain amount of time, you are considered dead, and I believe it's been close to about a minute now. It does not look like the Vexagon will be getting back up anytime soon. Ooh. Actually, it's lifting now. See, if it does get up in the next few seconds, I will allow this to continue, but... okay, yeah, no, unfortunately, I am going to have to enforce the rules. The Vexagon is not flying at this point in time. I assume that if we go over here, yeah, we have an altitude of about 95 for that craft, apparently. So, the Twin Skulls are within the play area still, whereas the Vexagon and Luminar no longer are. So I will be calling this first match in favor of the Twin Skulls. Alright guys, here we go with the second matchup between these two, with the Vexagon and Lumina spawning in second this time. We see so many missiles coming off the front of the Vexagon there, just streaking towards that front skull. And just knocking it pretty much immediately out of the air. Let's try and find our Lumina fighter this time, try and keep a little bit more, a bit better a track of what's going on with that this time around. So as you can see, we already got one skull down. The remaining skull sending off a fair bit of firepower of its own, doing rather well to survive its initial pass with the Vexagon there. I haven't really seen much coming out of the Lumina yet that I can tell. I just want to try and, as we missed it last time, I want to try and focus on it a little bit more this time around. The Vexagon continuing to just put out massive barrages of missiles, which seem to be doing fairly well at connecting as well. As you can see, we've got this skull having a little bit of trouble staying level. Is it going down now, or has it managed to ride itself? I do like this design of how it's got the missiles coming out of its mouth and all that. Really cool design. Possibly not the most practical design, but definitely deserves points just on the creativity of it. Though it is actually, I say that, but they are doing quite well actually when I think about it. But definitely one of our slower entrants. As you can see, the Lumina jet, they're doing quite well to outrun those missiles before unfortunately turning around just a little too early and running into the last few. So yeah, we have the one skull down, which might be repairing. The Vexagon has kind of slowed down. The Lumina's having some trouble steering by the looks of things right now. So we see a few missiles coming on and hitting the tail there, taking out quite some of the jets and the tail sections, which would be making it very difficult for the Lumina to control itself right now, as you can see. Though that missile may have kind of helped balance things out a little bit there, actually. Let's go over and check on the Vexagon. It's still up, but it is taking a bit of a beating right now. Appears to maybe have some damage to its weapon system, actually. It is not launching any missiles right now. Actually, is the Lumina launching anything? Here we go, we got some missiles coming out of the Lumina now. Just a nice frag. It looks like not many of those fragmental bits, unfortunately, actually hit the skull. Looks like it got a bit of a glancing blow there. Seeing some more missiles coming out from the Vexagon now. Ooh, a rather large explosion within this Twin Skull. Another one's still down now, not managing to repair yet. And it looks like this Twin Skull is going down. I will get my timer ready in just a moment, guys. Alright, let's start a timer for 1 minute from now. And if neither of these twin skulls manage to get back up out of the water with their balloons within this minute, we will be calling this match in favour of the Vexagon and Lumina. So that we can just see the little bit of a overview of how they're doing this time. And this time around, the Vexagon going a lot better than last time. As you can see, it's still very high percentage here. Both the Twin Skulls down at around 64% right now. And unfortunately, they have not managed to get back up out of the water. So we are now tied one apiece. We will be going to a tiebreaker between these two to see who continues on in the upper bracket and which entrant will be dropping down to the lower bracket. Alright guys, and here we go with the final matchup between these two. Loaded the Twin Skulls in sideways, just a bit of a mix-up. I loaded the Vexagon and Lumina side on in the first round, I believe. So maybe this time around we won't see the initial strike taking out one skull immediately. It just seemed fair to do as I did do it for the Vexagon and Lumina earlier on. Though it looks like the initial alpha strike from the Vexagon has once again disabled one of the skulls pretty much immediately. You see that going down on our screen right now. However, it looks like in passing they got a few hits onto the Lumina fighter. That is going down as well. So it looks like this battle will now be between... Ooh, actually they hit both skulls. The other skull went down as well. Or maybe just lost a bit of control. It's going back up. It's pretty well fine. And unfortunately the first skull as well managing not going down, unfortunately, for the Vexagon, despite all that massive damage it took right to the face. As we can see, large amounts missing of it. If that manages to stay up though, this will be a 2-on-1 dogfight. In favor of the Twin Skulls. Really am quite impressed with the resilience of the Twin Skulls, actually. They don't look like they, from the outside, it looks like they wouldn't be too hard to really knock out of the air, but they can take quite a beating before they do go down. Same with the Vexagon, of course, that is doing quite well. In fact, it has managed to fight off the two of these rather well, and it looks like it may actually pull this win out of the bag at this point in time. The Twin Skulls not really getting much damage that I can see onto it, though that was quite a few missiles that made direct impact just there. Perhaps we just check the percentages here. Yeah, as you can see, the Vexagon quite high. One of the twins actually no longer registering, does not have a AI anymore. So, yeah, I believe that's probably this one over here. Looks like it's just a bit of a husk, really. Yeah. That, oh wow, I just noticed the whole jaw moving thing. That is really cool. And now the other one has gone down. So technically right now, this Twin Skull doesn't have an AI or anything. So I guess kind of technically this is dead, I think. So what do we got here? 602 alive. Yeah, it's pretty much a dead ship right now, so I think, depending on, maybe the Vexagon is going to target it and take it out anyway. Looks like it. We have quite a few missiles coming out. See if I can get a good view of these hitting. Ooh. So it looks like we had a mixture of frags, explosives, and ion missiles in that barrage. And there we go, this Twin Skull now falling out of the sky. We will start our minute timer. And if this Twin Skull cannot get itself back up into the necessary altitude, which looks like it just lost quite a few of its balloons. So it's pretty well a foregone conclusion here. I did give it the minute anyway. Just giving a quick look at this hexagon before I cut to the next matchup. Just like the rotating pods on the sides here. I think they fire off flares, actually, from what I was seeing. I know it does have flare missiles. So yeah, but we are calling this match in favor of the Vexagon and Lumina. They will be continuing on in our upper bracket. The Twin Skulls did quite well. Thank you, Zionics, for your entry there. You will be unfortunately going down to the lower bracket, but you still have a good chance of staying in the competition. And Abye's Vexagon and Lumina are our first winners, continuing on into the upper bracket for this competition. Alright guys, so for our second matchup, we will have the Stingray from Hyper Psychos. That's this here, and that will be going head to head with the Squee from Falcon 256. And here we have Falcon 256's Squee. He's asked for me to spawn a Chinon facing a little bit away from the enemy. So I haven't done directly away this time. I might do that for the next matchup. And of course, also have to... Can't just give orientation favor to one player in every single spawn. So like, I will be doing it in a variety of positions, depending how many matches we go through to. But I did spawn it facing a little bit away for this time around. And let's just speed things up and let's see how the action begins to unfold. So as we can see there, the Squee has a laser on. I'm pretty sure the Stingray actually has a laser on the front as well. So this might be a bit of a laser battle. It looks like these are both very fast craft as well. So I might be having a little bit of difficulty keeping up with the action here this time around, guys. Sorry about that. So it looks like at the moment the Squee has the advantage in that its laser is mounted on a turret. Stingray letting off a nice volley of missiles, which are being taken out by anti-missile lasers here. See quite a few frags coming out though. Maybe they got a little bit of damage onto the Squee. Bit hard to tell. I may go into the strategic view and just see if I can keep an eye on the overview of this, as they are quite far away from each other. And it's very difficult with how fast they are flying to get any real idea of what's going on. As we can see, the Squee has this laser constantly sending out damage, whereas the Stingray, like I said, I'm pretty sure it's only got that laser on its front, and it's having a little bit of difficulty getting the correct angle to attack with that right now. Just trying to get itself around, getting chunked by these lasers from the Squee. You can hear the occasional explosion. Just does not seem to be able to turn fast enough to get that correct angle with its lasers. And it possibly doesn't even have power now, as we did see it get... I thought it was going to get within firing range then for a second there, but it did not. Now going down, got some balloons to save it from the ocean, so it has not dropped out of play just yet. Where is it? Completely lost track of where our Squee is right now. That's a very nice long-range circling design. So this is going to be a difficult one for the Stingray to bring back, I think. Just try and get over here and get a look at this. So yeah, we have just the giant rotating laser. Also looks like it's got some missiles set on the same turret so that they're always facing the enemy as well. Very fast. Actually, taking itself low enough to need to deploy its balloons just to get back up in the air. And yeah, if we come back over here, as we can see, Stingray is now down in the water. I'll let this play out for a minute, as I always do, just to be 100% sure, but looks like right now this first round will go to the Squee, which was a submission from Falcon 256. Alright guys, there we go. So we are calling, officially calling this round in favour of the Squee, and we will continue on to the second matchup between these two to see if Hyper Psychos Stingray can come back and continue on within the and have a chance at the upper bracket in this tournament or not. Alright guys, here we go. We have the Stingray spawning in second this time around, possibly getting a more favourable start as well. More of a direct run off the initial pass here, so we do see some damage actually go out immediately onto the squee. However, ooh, it actually crashed. Wow, seems to be very, very fragile. Hopefully it does manage to get back up from this. See a lot more missiles coming down once again. A large amount of damage. I do have to start my timer for if the squee cannot get up out of the water, it is technically out of play. It just, as you can see guys, the huge difference just your starting orientation can make, which is why I do try to mix it up and not give the preferred starting advantage to one contestant repetitively, like kind of thing. So though if this does end badly for the squee, I always do try to do my tiebreaker matches at extreme distance, give both ships time to orientate themselves correctly, so it does still stand a good chance the same thing will not happen in the third matchup, which is looking like we will be going to, because we are just about out of time on our minute. Just 4 seconds, 3, 2, 1, and unfortunately not the most satisfying matchup, but because of the rules for this tournament, we are looking for flyers, and the squee has been in the water for over a minute now, so we will be calling this matchup in favor of Hyperpsychos' Stingray. Unfortunately, the squee getting up, but just a little too late, guys. I've already called it, so I'm very sorry, Falcon 256, but you will be going through to a tiebreaker with the Stingray, and we will do that right now. Alright guys, here we go with the final tiebreaker between these two. As promised, I've gone extreme distance for this spawning. I didn't spawn facing backwards as requested, however, because I did have that initial match where I did spawn the squee facing fairly well away from its opponent. So they also requested like maximum range if possible, so this should be a fair enough match, I believe, for these two. Just turn the HUD off. Sorry guys, I forgot about that last time around. Actually had a crash a bit earlier, so probably ended up cutting that out of the video because it was just after I started the second matchup, and nothing had really happened. So we do see the Stingray has actually gone down. Got quite a bit of balloons there, still got jet propulsion. So does look like it will be coming back up any moment now. Maybe spoke too soon. I will start my timer just in case. So that's starting now, 1 minute. It would be unfortunate if we have two matchups end rather quickly just because ships are out of play, but it was clear to define in the rules that anything play is defined, I believe it was between 50 and 500 altitude. May have even been 100, but I'm pretty sure I did it as 50. I should probably know the rules to my own tournament, shouldn't I guys? Anyway, unfortunately right now Stingray is technically out of play. Squee, as you can see, took a fair bit of damage this time around, luckily managing to stay in the air though, unlike the last round where that initial volley was enough to just ground it. Looks like our minute is up for the Stingray. Very sorry that things turned out like this, Hyperpsychos. It was a close matchup between these two, depending on the spawning situation. And unfortunately with these tournaments, it's a bit hard to work out exactly how to spawn things to give the evenest, like the without giving advantage to one over the other. I tried my best to make it as even possible. I hope you're happy with how I did, but you will be still in the competition in the lower bracket, Hyper Psychos, and Falcon 256 the Squee will be continuing on in our upper bracket for round two. Congratulations. Alright guys, in our third matchup for today, we have the Vulture from Ryation, which you can see right here, and that will be going head to head with the Speedy Venus from Tajima. I believe that's how I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to pronounce that three as an E. So yeah, that we'll be up against. This is the Vulture, and be going up against the Speedy Venus. And here we have the Speedy Venus. This is the Mark III, I believe. Very similar as to what has been seen, the submarine we've seen in the Alpha Masters tournament. So it'd be interesting to see how this one goes as a jet as opposed to a submarine, and of course much smaller due to the block limit. But let's speed things up and get this match underway. We see some lasers and missiles coming out from the Speedy Venus here. Is this all fight? What does the Vulture have? Oh, we see the Vulture letting off a lot of missiles over there. Are they missiles coming into attack or decoy missiles? They look like... Yes, they're coming towards the Speedy Venus, which the Speedy Venus is really fast, so... possibly missiles will not be overly effective. How exactly... Oh, we got some lasers on here as well. That's good. So not all of those lasers coming out are from the Speedy Venus. I really like this design, just in, it's very much a great Top Gun design, a proper fighter jet. Really, really a fan of that, a very good design from Ryation here. Not that I got anything against the Speedy Venus, you know, gotta love those colours. And, so yeah, with Speedy Venus is very fast with those matching laser turrets. The Vulture, reasonably fast itself, but I don't think it has, like, the Speedy Venus has a really large custom jet, I'm pretty sure. Ooh, it looks like the Vulture has actually lost propulsion, maybe going down right now. Looks like the missiles from the Speedy Venus actually doing more than the lasers itself this time around. I will just begin my minute timer as the Vulture is down in the water now. Let's just get a bit of a top-down view of the Venus circling around the Vulture right now. I believe it's... How far away is it, actually? It's in a different map sector, so I can't... Oh, wait, there he is. Wow. That is a very large circling diameter. As we can see, we've got these missiles here all slowly streaking their way in. Just zoom in a bit to see these. Oh, they actually fell a little bit short, but these lasers, of course, constantly. Oh, there we got some missiles landing. Lasers not always hitting, actually. But yeah, unfortunately, it looks like the Vulture has not done too well in this first matchup between these two. So, still got about 7 seconds left before I call this. And that is the minutes up now. So, unfortunately, the Vulture has lost the first matchup. However, it is best out of three, as with every other matchup. So, we will return this time with the Vulture spawning in second for our second matchup. Alright, guys, here we go with the second matchup. Ryation has actually requested that he be spawned facing backwards or side on to his opponent. That is why you see him racing away from the Speedy Venus right there at the start while launching off a few missiles back behind it. So yeah, we see quite a few missiles coming in. Any of them actually making contact with the Venus though? Ooh, looks like it's just a little too fast. The Vulture doing quite well itself to actually outrun the Venus's missiles as it makes a circle around. Looks like... No, for a second there I thought it had lost one of its lasers, but it has not. They're both intact. And this time around it seemed to, unfortunately it didn't maintain that attack angle. Really needs to get its lasers focused on the Speedy Venus, I believe. It's not going to have much luck hitting it with these missiles until it manages to slow it down a little bit. We come over to take a look at the Venus. Has taken some damage to the tail, it would appear. Really difficult for me to keep up with this guy's arm. If I remember correctly from, like, looking when I first loaded this thing in, it goes at 170. So yeah, very, very fast. And we had something happen to the Vulture while we're trying to keep an eye on the Venus. Looks like it took a fair amount of damage. It's not going down yet. Does it still have its lasers intact? It still has one laser intact. Unfortunately, just not getting that correct angle very often. Their attack angle very limited compared to the full 360 degree motion of the turrets on the Venus. Having a little bit of trouble with its angle right here, but I'm managing to stay up in the air, but not really getting much forward momentum, unfortunately. Still, it has found an angle for its laser. Just a few key hits here. Anything that's going to slow the Venus down could give the Vulture a chance. But not. Unfortunately, we haven't seen the Venus take that many hits, so we're not sure just how durable it is. May not be that easy to slow down. The Vulture has done rather well in riding itself here, though, and staying in the competition. Things were looking pretty bad for it just then. Well, unfortunately, it looks like it has had its jets disabled this time around and is going down into the water. It's time to once again begin our timer, though this looks pretty well like a foregone conclusion in favor of the Speedy Venus. I don't see the Vulture really getting back up without any defenses. It doesn't appear to have any smoke to stop these lasers, unfortunately. Alright guys, and that is it. That is our minute. Unfortunately, the Vulture just has been overwhelmed by the insane speed of the Speedy Venus, so rather appropriately named. So the Vulture will be going down to the lower bracket for round 2, and the Speedy Venus from Tajima will be continuing on in our upper bracket. Alright guys, for our final matchup here we have the Fury and Fighter Swarm from Goduranus. Not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly. It's a single word, God and Uranus. Goduranus, I guess. Yes, and anyway, this is the Fury and Fighter Swarm, so I think we got an Interceptor class here, which is the Fury, and they will be going up against the Tiny Borg Armageddon from Mr. Ribena. And here we have a quick look at the Tiny Borg Armageddon, six little Borg fighters from Mr. Ribena. Alright, let's get into this, guys. Let's speed this app back up and see how the action unfolds. A lot of missiles coming out from the Tiny Borg Swarm, Armageddon. Immediately, we heard some cannon fire. I think that was coming from the Interceptor, the Fury, down there. It's going to be a bit hard for me to get everything in view here with these swarm fights. Wow, we see a lot of missiles coming off of the Fighter Swarm there. Doing a lot of damage to the Borg. Looks like they're just a little slow on their start. So really kind of just sitting ducks for all these missiles for the Alpha Strike from the Fighter Swarm. And it looks like... Yes, unfortunately for the Borg, the Fighter Swarm has rather quickly decimated their forces. looks like all we have left is a few missile racks here. I'll just check our AI list. And yes, indeed, we have no Borg fighters left. That was a very quick match. Hopefully the Borg fighters can, the tiny Borg Armageddon can put up a little bit better of a fight in our second matchup between these two. Alright guys, here we go with the second matchup between these two, this time with the Furion Fighter Swarm spawning in second. As we speed up the action here, we can see that cannon on the Fury immediately starting to fire. Wondering why they seem to be taking a while to start going anywhere. What is... not entirely sure what's happened here. Okay. I've messed up and spawned these guys. Spawned everyone in space, so I'll restart this round. Sorry guys, I wasn't paying attention to how high I was. Alright guys, here we go. This time loaded in within the atmosphere at the correct altitude, so we should see everyone take off immediately. There we go, that's much better. Let's see if we can follow the Fury into combat here. If I can keep up, it is very fast. Wow. Sit launching all those missiles and then immediately outrunning them. Good connection with one of the Borg off that volley as well. As we see, oh wow, the Alpha Strike of the Fighter Swarm coming in behind it now. Wow, we have a lot of destruction going onto the Borg right now. Not even sure where... oh yeah, all their fighters are now... the Swarm is now in amongst the Borg. Is there any Borg actually still firing back? Or has the Alpha Strike of the Fighter Swarm just completely decimated them? Wow. So this was just a very one-sided match. The Borg drones just not having the maneuverability to avoid the damage from that Alpha Strike, and whereas the Fighter Swarm very maneuverable in itself, and yeah, a very large Alpha Strike as well. So that does conclude all our opening matchups for today. We do have one more entrant which has not been revealed yet. That is our entry from Miss Ion, I believe. The 600 Reasons it is called, and they got a pass this round. They got the first bye, and will be going up against the Vexagon and Lumina, I believe, next up in our next round. Probably leave that till next time. Alright guys, so here we have the 600 Reasons. This is our craft that got a bye. I'm gonna have to slow things down because it is very fast, and bringing up now, you should have the current standings of the table, our winners and losers for today, now being split into upper and lower brackets. And next time around, we will do the, I think I'll just do a quick one, try and get the odd ones out. So I think I'll do the upper bracket and the one lower bracket, so that from then on, it's all... no more having to deal with the slight offset single match due to the bye. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this first round of the tournament. As always, I really appreciate your feedback on the video quality and how I'm doing things. So yeah, please be critical, and I'll leave a comment down below if you have anything to say. If you enjoyed the action, hit the like button, and possibly subscribe to keep up with the future rounds. And until next time guys, have fun building in From the Depths.